And you didn't want to tell me what you were into
with
either.
With good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that was settled.
You
Oh. What do you want?
Well, you're just going around knocking on doors? Stirring the pot.
Snow sent me. Said you wanted to talk.
Not me.
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
You think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I?
So have you, Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this. I've had to hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there?
If you don't want to talk, can you just get Beauty for me?
I don't know. Is it safe to turn my back? It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into this.
Beast!
I just don't think we can trust him. Not after the way he went behind my back. Mm-hmm. And then you run and call him again?
Talk about living in the past.
He was keeping secrets for you.
Mm-hmm. It was one little thing. Do you want to keep fighting about that? Or do you want to try to sort this out?
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring him here.
We're out of money. And answers.
Oh. Thanks for letting us finish our conversation.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I wanna know. What are you trying to say, huh?
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Is this something about that loan you took out? From the crooked man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate
things. I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
I'd like to help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the Crooked Man? What if we talk and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the Crooked Man. And I don't know if it's worth it.
I can protect you, but only if you tell me what I need to know. And that means details. No more stonewalling.
We aren't.
Then just tell me what's going on here.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn, and we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just
you're telling me. Working this is tough right now.
Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
Can we finish this conversation first?
I should get that.
So leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as... humanly possible.
Beep!
Jesus Christ.
That fucking message. I'm gonna come down there and bash your heads in with that machine if I have to call again and hear that fucking message one more time. I've been doing this long enough to know that if you had the cash, you'd have paid by now. So consider yourselves out of warnings. It's time to start thinking about how else you can settle this.
Who is that?
Crooked Man.
The Crooked Man's gonna get his, one way or another.
Okay.
All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
Did you ever see the Crooked Man there? When you got your loan? Or just shopping?
No, never. But, come on, it's his place. And the Jersey Devil never lets you forget it. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times, too. There's a lot of that going around.
What the hell are you doing hanging out at a place like the Lucky Pawn anyway?
Sometimes fables sell things they brought from the homelands. Things you can't find anywhere else.
You do know there's a difference between pawning something and selling it, don't you?
I know that.
You're buying a piece of someone else's misery. With money you don't have.
Well, that's over now. Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And...
me.
You know that butcher shop, the cut above? It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker.
Oh, that's the same with Auntie.
Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages.
Well, what are you delivering? What's going on there? How does this fit into the Crooked Man's operation?
I couldn't tell you, but I do know this. It's the only meat market in town that doesn't carry filet. I'm not sure how much actual butchery goes on there.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the Butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up, and it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was.
So you do their dirty work. Look the other way.
Work is work. All I do is deliver stuff.
Yeah, I feel you. I'd just be driving.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like
just a hard-working man.
To get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
Yeah, with all this luxury stuff you'd be buying, goddamn.
No, probably not.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Alright, so, going to Lucky Pawn.
I'm going to the Lucky Pawn. There's too much going on there to ignore. I'll have a word or two with Jersey.
You know, Bigby, once you show your face there, word is going to get out. There may be nothing left to see if you go to the butcher shop after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Look at the soundtrack. Wait, what the hell?
I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but is there
like
any
the
way you could help us out?
What do you mean?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
Are we making
we
a deal?
Would really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
I'll handle it. I'm not gonna let that crooked bastard ruin any more lives.
Oh, thank you, Bigby.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
Mm-hmm. there was a wolf. There was a wolf.